I'm going to be shooting some B-roll with Simon. He is an amazing artist, and I'm going to be showcasing some of his work today. And, so that we will bring a lot more business to Silver City and showcase the beautiful and wonderful individuals that live here. So stay tuned.
Like on the, you know, way out there on the, in the Arroyo?
Yes.
So that's where I actually collect her from. Because you know how they just put it all in, you know, out in the Arroyo behind, way back there?
Mm-hmm.
We just decided to go for a hike through there one day.
Then you grew up there. It's part of your
Arroyo. Hi, I'm Simon Sotelo, and this is my gallery opening. It's December 5th, Silver City. It's called Icon, and it's basically based on the idea that people have taken religious icons and they've turned them into everyday objects that we see every day, and they've kind of overused them a little bit. A lot of the pieces that are put together is a collection of stuff that I've picked up on hikes and just around town. One of the other things with this collection, though, too, is this is the first time I've ever done anything like this. Most people know me for jewelry, they know me for porcelain, for painting, but they don't really know that there's a lot of world of art out there that I want to explore. So this is the first time I've actually done anything like this. Me personally, I'm very proud of it because, again, I pushed myself out of my comfort zone, the things that people normally know me for. So I hope that you guys enjoy it. I hope you guys enjoy it.
Tell us a little bit about the chandelier here. What inspired that?
Actually, the inspiration from the chandelier came from just wanting to be able to use a lot of stuff that I had. And I have, most artists, we kind of become semi-hoarders. And that's a horrible term to say, but it's true. So I had a problem with, you know, buying broken chandeliers, and then I just decided I can use them for this assemblage piece. So all of the pieces come, the light fixture came from an old house that was torn down in my neighborhood. It was a newer fixture, and when they tore it down, I got the light fixture, and I've added the skulls and the crystals too. But the inspiration actually just came from wanting to use stuff that I already had, because that was the whole purpose of this, is ready-made objects, you know, for assemblage. So
like recycling type of thing?
Yeah.
Yeah, just...
No, yeah.
And so all these, you said before, came from a cemetery?
No, not every single icon in here came from a cemetery. The only one that actually did was this one.
Okay. Do they have names?
Yeah, this one I believe, I'm not exactly sure what her name is, but all the pieces have names. This is Our Lady of Fierro Cemetery, because that's where I actually picked her up at.
Okay.
There's a Santo Niño de Atocha, which is Patriot Saint of Pilgrims, and there's a whole history behind a lot of, you know, religious iconography.
Okay, excellent.
Yeah, this is another set, some of yours. of the larger bowl. Most of the porcelain sells on the goodness is now available. So the
I bought a set.
Yeah,
you bought a set.
Yeah,
and then you bought
one of the last. Where'd you get
this?
Yeah,
just
yeah, of course.
I don't know.
Just
pry them out. No, we didn't find them. Yeah, of course not. So you see what it's by two. Huh? These are new tiles.
From where?
From the 70s. So when I inherited my house, there was like four boxes, and I opened them up, and all these
people
were
talking.
That's
really
cool.
You
were
meant to.
I was just waiting for you. See, the kids, we got the girl in the class.
Yeah.